This New York Times best-selling author is known for Gunmetal Grey and co-authoring Tom Clancy's Jack Ryan novels.
His Grey Man series is just off the charts, as you know. Well, now he's out with a new high-stakes thriller that's a standalone, perhaps a new series. Mm. Mark Greaney is here with more on his latest book, Red Metal, which is kind of a nightmarish the whole scenario. But one really cool thing, Mark, and welcome back.
Thank you very much for having me.
You co-wrote this with someone who has a long history in the military. How did all that happen?
In 2014, I was working on a Tom Clancy novel. I met Hunter Rawlings is his name, Lieutenant Colonel. He was sort of a technical advisor a little bit on a Clancy book, but we just became really good friends, and I'd go up and stay with him and his family in Arlington. He got stationed out at Camp Pendleton in California.
Was fascinated with the writing process.
Yeah, he was a writer already. He hadn't been published, and he'd give me some stuff to read, and of course it was good. But we just started feeding off of our ideas, and it took us 3 years, and we wrote a 91-chapter outline and decided to go get a book deal for it.
That is amazing. So what did you feel and find the Lieutenant Colonel brought to the table, and how different of a process was this for you, especially to collaborate?
Well, he and I both were huge fans of a Tom Clancy book called Red Storm Rising, which came out in the mid-80s.
Huge book.
So we started by sort of talking about that and reimagining a Russian invasion of Europe and, in our case, Africa as well. And so we spent time talking about that, and I just saw his creativity as well as all of his military knowledge. And we worked really well together. He would send me something. We fought over every word. Mm-hmm.
You fought over every word.
Well, not necessarily. I would have lost a bad fight.
You're an introvert. You're a control freak over your work.
That's
which
true.
Is one reason why it's so excellent. That had to be a little hard for you.
It was tough to get that in and start editing it. And, you know, we had to speak in one voice. So it's just a lot of work. The book is 217,000 in its final form, words, 650-something pages.
Wow.
So it's a big novel.
You talked about this Russian invasion. In reality, in real life, a lot of people will wonder, could this potentially really happen? What do you think?
The way that we have drawn it up, it can. A normal, massive, large front invasion, there's something called strategic surprise, and there's no way the Russians could achieve strategic surprise. Our spies and our satellites would see that build up. But in ours, it's more of an operational raid than a mass invasion, and they spearhead into Europe for an objective while simultaneously spearheading south into Africa.
You very closely watch, and with your background, you know what's going on. Mm-hmm. Is this potentially possible in today's environment, and would the U.S. under current administration be as diligent, in your belief,
That's a great question. I will say that it could happen.
Is that their goal?
If there was a large-scale conflict, it would start with a bunch of saber rattling, which we've always seen, and then there would be something to kick it off. In our case, there's a rare earth mineral mine in Africa that Russia fictionally has possession of, and then the West wrestles possession from them, and they decide for their own political and personal fortunes they have to go get it back.
Okay.
And so that's the thing that kicks it off. Okay. If there is a World War III, it will be a lot of conflict and, you know, hegemons going at each other, and then it'll be like one little thing that'll kick it off, and that's what we do.
Will we be diligent enough? Are we diligent enough right now against Russia in particular?
The whole premise of our story, the invasion happens at Christmas. NATO is very, very thin right now. Even U.S. forces in NATO are thin. Yeah. At Christmas, everybody's thinner. And the whole premise of our story is we're not quite diligent enough at first, but we rally as we did in the Second World War.
You are known for being so meticulous, and you do so much research ahead of time, and especially working with the Lieutenant Colonel. What other research went into this project for you?
I spent quite a bit of time in Poland. Rip was in France, and we met in Germany, and we went up and down Germany, talked to a Panzer general, former Panzer general. We went out to Nellis Air Force Base and worked with the A-10 training squadron out there. He got on a submarine, a nuclear submarine, and went up to the Pentagon and all those sorts of things. So we researched for a couple of years.
Could this be your new series?
I hope so. You know, depending on sales, which look pretty good so far, you know, they might want another one for us, and we kind of hope they do.
They better. All right.
We still hope for that Greaney
movie.
Glad
to have you back.
Every time
Thank
we see you, we ask about
Thanks.
The Greaney movie.
Always good to see you.
Appreciate it.
All right. We're going to take a short break. More Live at 9 in just a moment.